What's up, everybody? I'm Jesse Showalter, and today I'm really excited to be taking a look at Adobe Experience Design. XD is part of the Adobe suite that's primarily focused on UI design, UX design, prototyping, and responsive web design. It's available for both Mac and PC as long as you have an Adobe CC subscription. It's most definitely a competitor to a lot of the modern design tools that have come out recently and that you might be using, like Sketch or Figma or the dozen others that are on the market right now. In today's video, I'm gonna be covering the top 10 things you need to know about XD when you first open up the project to help you get up and running and feeling really confident about the program. I'm ready to get started. I hope you are. Let's do this thing. Before I get started, this video is sponsored by the awesome people over at Dev Mountain. Dev Mountain is a bootcamp experience that offers on-campus and online programs for people who want to start a new career in design or development. If you're interested in learning web development, iOS development, UX design in a 13-week program that'll spit you out career ready, then check out the link in the description and check out Dev Mountain. Okay, let's jump right into the computer and figure out what the 10 basic things are that you need to know. I'm just gonna roll down. I'm gonna open up Adobe XD from my dock. Just a quick note before we start, I am using an Apple computer, and so I'm not really accustomed to PC commands, and so I'm just gonna say what they are on my machine, and you figure out what they are on your machine. How about we do that? Okay, when I open up XD for the very first time, you're gonna see I have the option to start with a tutorial, but we have all the different screen resolutions down here. We can open up the different sizes all the way up to iPhone X and the different tablets and standard kind of browser sizes. And we have some different UI kits that we can open up over here. Let's just start out with an iPhone X and we'll open up the program. And you can see it opens it right up and it's dropped an artboard onto our canvas. The artboard system is a really common thing nowadays in modern design tools, and XD is no different. It allows you to put new artboards onto the canvas anytime you want. You can do that by rolling over here into the tools panel, and there's an artboard tool, or you can use the hotkey of A, and you can either do one of two things. You can draw out a custom sized artboard. I'm just gonna press Command Z to undo that, or you can choose from the different selections that they have. Like we have iPhone X up here, or maybe we wanted to do like an Android mobile device as well. And then maybe after that, we wanna do like an iPad to the right of it. Every time you put an artboard down on the screen, it's going to just space it out to the right. And also with artboards, you can press the V command or use your selection tool. And you can grab the artboards by grabbing the top kind of portion or the name of that artboard, and you can move it around the canvas. And you get some automatic snapping for spacing and all that kind of good stuff. But that's the first thing you need to know, is how to make artboards, how to move them, and also how to resize them simply by clicking the different corners and resizing like that. All right, so the second thing you probably need is a basic tour or understanding of the interface. And so that's what we're gonna do right now in a very general fashion, not real in-depth. We're just gonna kind of cruise through the interface and show you what we have. On the very left-hand side, we kind of already covered it. We have the tools panel where you can drop in different shapes or lines. You can use your pen tool, text, and you can zoom in. Each of these have a hotkey that you can learn to kind of speed up your workflow. Down at the bottom of the same panel, you can see we have either layers, and that has a hotkey as well, or you can click over to the assets. The assets is where XD is gonna store all of your colors and your character styles and your reusable symbols or components you can reuse through your project. And so knowing how to click back and forth between your layers and your symbols or your layers and your assets, really, really powerful part of XD. Right next to that, we have all of the artboards displayed, and you can see all three of them on their own separate line. Up at the top left, you can see we are currently on the design tab, and we'll talk about this later, but we can click over to the prototyping tab. We're able to create interactions between our kind of artboards and create interactive prototypes. So that's the difference between those two tabs. We have our name, obviously, of our project, and then you have some of those basic controls on the top right, like zoom in, zoom out, like what percentage are we currently looking at it. We want to device preview it or desktop preview it, like so. We can share this design, and then you have all your basic tools. If I just draw a rectangle, you can see over in my properties panel, you have all your alignment tools, some interesting repeat grid kind of stuff. You have your pathfinder or your Boolean operations. You have all of your different properties for your width and your height and the X and Y values. And we have some different prototyping options, as well as all of our appearance options like color and text and typography and different stroke sizes. So all that good stuff is there. And that is a basic tour of the interface. All right, the third thing you might want to know how to do using Adobe XD, like any other Adobe product, is to use the pen tool. And that's by simply clicking on the pen tool in the tools panel or by pressing the hotkey of P. Once I do that, I get my pen icon and I can start adding nodes to my artboard and create custom shapes, filling those custom shapes with color, coming back and readdressing the individual nodes. I can add new nodes by hovering over any line. I can also delete each node one at a time by pressing the delete key, and it will just slowly move around and delete each of those points. A few interesting things about the pen tool in Adobe XD is that if you start drawing with the pen tool, and like most other Adobe products, and you hold as you are making that second point, you start getting some simple Bezier curves. I can hold down shift and get increments, or I can just kind of freeform it by doing it with nothing but my hand. Once I release and I've created a Bezier curve, here's where XD's pen tool gets a little bit interesting. It's gonna force a curve to take place. It will not allow you to come out straight. It's gonna automatically kind of smart bend or bow the curve. I don't know if that's a good thing or a bad thing. It's just a thing. If I create a straight line, you'll see that I get a straight line off of this. If I'm creating a Bezier curve with my pen tool and I hold down the Option key, like in most other programs, I can just control one of the handles instead of both of the handles to give myself a little bit more control of where I'm going to go next. But that automatic curve thing, it's a little bit interesting. The fourth thing that you're gonna wanna know about in Adobe XD is about styles and reusable symbols. We've created kind of a funky shape on my canvas, and I can select that shape and just fill it with a really ugly color. That's not such an ugly color. But now let's say I wanted to make this some sort of reusable component that I could use over and over. This is a bad use case. It'd probably be something more like a button or a logo or a certain style that you have going on in your project. But for our example, this will do. If I wanted to create a reusable symbol out of this element though, I would roll all the way over to the left and down between my assets and my layers panels, and I would turn on my assets panel. Now I have an assets panel that's here. There's a few things I can do while I'm here in my assets panel. I could probably create a reusable color. So now we have the border color and the fill color that are both a part of now the rest of this design, and I can always come back and reuse those styles. I can also create a reusable symbol, and I can rename this symbol. I'll call it blah, because that's what it looks like to me. And anytime I wanted another one of these, I could either option drag another one out, or I could drag one from my assets panel. And there it is. I like this. It's a nice visual representation of all your reusable components in your project. It's really, really nice. Symbols work in a very interesting way, I will say. You just take any one of the represented symbols on the canvas, and you can change the properties to it, which is kind of cool. I can also double click and change the size to this element. And when I do that, it changes every symbol, not only on the canvas, but also in the symbols panel. So that's kind of interesting. So now we've changed the size of our symbol. Maybe we like this color also, and we wanna add that color into our colors. We also have character styles. So I can use my text tool and just drag out some text and say, let's just write headline, and let's choose a headline. Like maybe we'll go grab Futura, and we'll use bold, and we'll fill it with black, and that's what we're gonna do. Let's maybe even bump up the size of our headline to something like 32, and then we can take that character style, and we can add it into our character styles panel. We can rename this, like maybe we want this just to be like H1. So now we have a headline, and anytime we had like some new text, we could start kind of typing up here. Let's say I was somehow on some sort of different kind of text that I was using. I can apply that character style simply by clicking on my new text and double clicking on my character style, and wha-bam, we have our headline style has been applied. One thing that I do really, really enjoy is if you have multiple of those styles or multiple of those symbols on one page or across different canvases, you can right click and highlight all of them on every canvas throughout your entire project. That's really, really cool as well. The fifth thing we're gonna be talking about in Adobe XD is, in my opinion, one of its coolest features, and that's its ability to repeat grids and speed up the design process with its repeatable grid feature. I've now created what I consider to be a reusable component. I'm gonna click back over to my layers view, and I'm gonna group that together. I'm just gonna call that card, okay? I want to perhaps make lots of these cards and then edit the spacing and how they all work together like all at one time instead of duplicating. That can get a little bit tedious. Instead, I can just click on the element I want to duplicate and head over to my properties panel and hit repeat grid. And now we get this little vertical and horizontal scroll bar that we can access however we want. So maybe we want these cards to go down. We can't. We just drag that thing down and all the copies of it appear. And now we have multiple copies that are being controlled by our grid. We can just kind of fix them like that. If we wanted to change or edit the spacing that we have of our cards in between from one to another, we can literally just double click on our grid and we can roll over those margined areas, grab, and just kind of stretch out to our liking. So now we can make it 10 pixels and release, and the whole thing updates. We can create less cards. I really enjoy this feature. I think it really speeds up kind of the rapid prototyping aspect of design, as well as some of that tedious kind of back and forth of spacing things. You don't have to do that because all that's taken care of right here in our repeat grid function. Okay, the sixth thing you're gonna wanna know about in Adobe XD is actually one of its newer updates, and that is responsive resizing right here within Adobe XD. The ability to create components and, you know, different pieces of design that can stretch in an intelligent way across all sorts of different device sizes. On the screen, we have two different artboards. We have an iPad and an iPhone, and over on my iPhone side, I've started designing a really, really basic application, right? Where we just have, if you click into it, you can see we have a nav up top, a little hamburger menu and a logo or whatever. We have a little hero with an image and some text kind of defining what it is, and a user card down below. We could see these user cards obviously like duplicating and they're all sitting in there like so. But we want all these elements to intelligently kind of respond to the device size over on the right hand side. Well, now when you click on any element in Adobe XD, in the properties panel, you're gonna get the responsive resize option. And by default, it's gonna be on for you. If we click over to manual, you can see what type of settings. So here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna click on my logo that's inside there, and then I'm going to click on manual and see how it has assigned its responsive resizing properties. It's smart enough to know that it's over on the left-hand side, so we wanna keep it anchored to the left. It's given it a fixed width and a fixed height. Okay, so now we wanna do the same thing. We're gonna click on our hamburger menu, same thing, fixed width, fixed height, and it's anchored to the right. Now we have the actual bar itself, the rectangle behind it, and that is going to be anchored to all sorts of sizes, but we do want it to have a fixed height. So now you can see our little kind of pinning action here. It's pinned, it means it's gonna stay anchored to the top and to the left and right of the screen as you stretch it. And that it's gonna have a fixed height, which means it's never going to get larger because that's not how mobile design works, right? We want to stretch across, but not necessarily get bigger. And so now I can take my navigation that we have here, and I'm just going to copy it and paste it into my design over here. We're gonna go in and just grab a few of these like same elements, and we're going to kind of just drop them over, and we're gonna see what happens when we try to stretch everything across. Everything stretches like we would want it to, so that's really, really nice. Our table cell stretch. Now we could, if we wanted to, stretch this out, but what's awesome is you'll notice if you look really closely, the pink lines that are appearing around my text, my typography, it is staying anchored to the left and to the bottom, just like it was assigned in its kind of responsive resizing options. And so that works really, really good. Now we can just continue to go on different artboards and have perfect responsive designs no matter what device size. Okay, the next thing you're gonna wanna know how to do is to preview your designs in XD. There's two ways you can preview designs. The first way is to roll up to the top right corner and press the play icon, and we're gonna get a previewer right here on our screen. This is really, really effective if you've gone through and done some prototyping, so now we can click from piece to piece and actually see how things work. You will notice also that if I move things around on my design, they are moving around live in my previewer. You also have the ability to record things right here and export different types of movie files, and you can share those with different people. The second way you can preview your designs is to head up to the top right and hit the actual device icon and make sure that you've downloaded the Adobe XD Viewer, and you're able to then, if you've saved it to the cloud, or you can do a live preview, and it's gonna load it right there on your device. It does require that you have your device plugged in to actually do that viewing, so you can't just do it by Bluetooth. But If anything was prototyped here, I'd be able to tap on the different areas and actually watch it interact and swipe in between screens. And so that's real nice. That's a good way to preview it as well. The next thing you're gonna wanna know how to do is work with images inside of Adobe XD. And that's really, really simple. If we just kind of zoom in and let's say we wanted an image on our screen, we could take an image and we can drop it in. And immediately this is just a straight up bitmap image and it's being dropped into our design. We can resize our image. We can also change the border radius of the image. It's just gonna kind of crop those in a little bit. We can also double click on the image and kind of move it around inside of its frame. So that's one way you can do it. The way I like to work with images inside of XD is actually to draw a shape and then take an image and try to drop it inside of the shape. Anytime you see a blue highlight, that's XD trying to mask that image into that shape. What's great about this technique is that you can actually move your shape around, change your shape, the size or the constraints of your shape, and it's gonna try to mask the image and keep it looking good. You can then also double click on the image and actually affect the image inside of the mask while still kind of keeping it constrained correctly. So that's working with images in XD. It's really, really easy, really nice. Okay, next thing we need to talk about is prototyping. It's kind of a big deal in XD. It's so big, it has its own tab up at the top. We were in the design tab, now we're in the prototyping tab. And prototyping is really, really easy. You're literally just gonna click on any sort of element that you want, like for instance, our card, and you'll get a little blue tab to the side of it. You grab that tab and just connect it to whatever artboard you'd like to go to, and you're gonna set the type of trigger, like for instance, a tap. We're gonna do a transition and we're gonna choose the destination to the second artboard there. And then we wanna choose some sort of transition. So we'd like to maybe slide up like a modal or something. And we're gonna do, let's do ease in and out, and we'll preserve the scroll position. That's good. And now when we grab our icon, we're gonna do the same thing. We're gonna transition back to here. And we will just do slide down. I like that Adobe XD actually remembers your last kind of constraints you put in. So it's remembering them and repeating them. So all I had to do is change from slide up to slide down and we are good to go. Now I can preview my design and you'll see when I roll over, I get some sort of like little hint that that's gonna work and it does the transition for me and I can transition back. So that's actually, that's really, really nice. I like that. We also have the ability to do timed transitions. So we can come in here and get to this artboard and create a timed transition on the artboard. So we could say after, let's do 3 seconds, that it will transition back to one by sliding down, or maybe we'll just do a dissolve out like that. Now when we preview, we're starting at home, we're going and we should count 1, 2, 3, it's gonna transition back out for us. So time transitions are kind of a new thing to XD, although prototyping is not. It's one of the main fundamental things you'd wanna use XD for, is to create these large scale interactive prototypes of your project and be able to share those with the people that you need to share them with. Which leads us to our final point. It's all about sharing. Sharing is caring, and XD is all about sharing. And so we are in our prototype view right now. Doesn't matter if you're in your design or prototype, the share icon will always show up in the very top right. And by clicking it, I can publish the prototype, publish some design specs, or make or manage my publish links. But first thing we're gonna do is publish our prototype. We're gonna allow for comments, open it in full screen. We wanna show the hints. Do we want a password to be required for somebody to have access to it? No, I don't think so. And we'll just name this prototype soccer and we'll create a public link. We can embed our prototype, we can grab the link and copy it and just share that in an email or a text message, or we can come over here and just open up the link in our browser. It's gonna open up that prototype and now people are able to go in and kind of view our prototype and click around and play with it. They don't have to have an application to check it out. They can just do it right here in the browser and that's pretty nice. Well, that's it. Those are the 10 things you need to know when you first open up Adobe XD. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to leave a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel. I do lots of videos about design and development and walkthroughs just like this one, so maybe stick around. If you have any questions, leave those down in the comments. I hope you guys are having an amazing week designing amazing things, making amazing things, and using the right tool for the job. I'll see you in the next one.